Ladies and gentlemen, we have a serious issue plaguing our classrooms today. Children just aren't engaged. We can't use the same techniques that we would have used 50 years ago, even 25 years ago. These children are changing, they have different problems, obstacles, things to overcome. So now, okay, we need to invest more of our time in stimulating our children, okay? Really stimulate them, okay? And the best way to do that is technology, okay? Kids get technology probably better than we do. They've grown up with it, they understand it, okay? It stimulates them. Now, with our technology, we will be able to organize lesson plans, grades, our own time, increase time management for efficiency. We spend thousands and thousands of dollars a year on textbooks, worksheets, paper, printers. But if we use technology, we can decrease those costs, but increase efficiency.
Ladies and gentlemen, due to outdated teaching techniques, the following scenarios are dangerously wrong and useless in the modern day classroom. Do not teach your students this way, ever.
Monday,
day after our break. Here I am, going up to our teacher, asking for my homework. Know what he does? Gives me the wrong one.
Hey, Professor Nerdenbach, where's my homework at, buddy?
It's around here somewhere.
Man, looks like you got a lot of work here.
Yeah, a lot of busy weekend.
Or trying to organize or something?
That one's not mine. Yeah, I think this is yours.
That's definitely not mine.
Well, it wouldn't matter anyway. You're going to fail anyway.
Well, alright. Thanks anyway.
On Wednesday, they're moving me to a new classroom. I don't really want to. They're talking about all computers and all this technology, but I don't even know what they're talking about. Emails and internet, I've never even heard of that. They think that it could really change my classroom around, but I don't really think it could happen.
What are all these things?
You guys know what these are?
They're computers.
Yeah.
Is that what I've been hearing all about? Research the internet?
Yep.
Brand spanking new.
These are the good ones, too.
What do you do with them?
400 hertz gigaprocessor.
You do whatever you want.
Yeah.
No viruses.
EBSCO host. You can look up articles.
PowerPoint.
Presentations.
Database.
Microsoft Office.
Excel. Word.
YouTube.
I don't know what to do.
Facebook.
You gotta check your email for our papers, don't you?
Yeah, I sent mine to you the other day.
It was an attachment.
What's an email? Do I have one?
Yeah, on the school website.
They gave me one? Well, I didn't get your paper. You got a zero.
What?
You had to hand it in.
I did. I sent it as an attachment.
Oh, I never got it. I don't even know how to use email. You knew that.
Well, you could just print it out when you get it on your email if you want.
No. I already graded a zero.
That's not fair.
You can't erase pen in those books.
Double tears.
So I emailed Professor Ted Ferguson and he didn't accept my paper. I sent it to him as an email and an attachment and he doesn't know how to work it, so I got a zero for it. I don't know, this is ridiculous. This is the 21st century, this is how we use computers nowadays, in the classroom, and yet he doesn't know how to do it. So now I get a zero for it. I don't think that's fair at all. It's not right.
Come in, Terry Ferguson.
Principal Finkelstein, you wanted to see me?
Yeah, I've had a few complaints from a few of the students that you haven't been checking your email and they haven't given or received any of their papers.
Well, I don't really know what to do. You know,
what's the problem?
Well, I've heard of people using email before, but I've never used it.
Never used it at all?
No, nobody's ever taught me how to use it.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, this poses a serious problem. When I talked to Ted Ferguson about his use of technology, I had no idea that he had no idea how to send an email, and now the complaints that I was getting from the students finally made sense. This guy has no idea how to use any kind of technology. So he left me with no option. I had to call him Frank.
you've got a problem with technology, I'm here to help you.
After learning technology from the Frank and how to use it in the classroom, I really think it's beneficial. First, I was really skeptical. I didn't know how it was going to work for my students, myself, and just overall. But after learning, I think it's really, really good.
After Mr. Ferguson learned how to use the computer properly, all my tests and papers are getting graded properly, too. Even that paper that I handed in to him that he gave me a 0 on, I got 100 on now. So it's pretty cool that he knows how to use technology. Because now my grades aren't going to fail, and I'm doing pretty good.
Now that Mr. Ferguson is better with technology, I actually get my homework back, and I get better grades, and he doesn't lose everything that I hand into him anymore. And I actually learn a lot more in his class now, because he's able to send me things even when I'm at home. Even when I'm home, I can go online, and I can search what he's teaching me, and everything works a lot better. He's a much better teacher now that he knows how to use technology.
After bringing in the Frank to help Turd Ferguson's class out, I feel that his class is a lot more organized and a lot more effective, and I've been getting a lot less complaints from all the students in his class, so I can finally eat my lunch on my lunch breaks instead of having them come to me with all these complaints.
In conclusion, ladies and gentlemen of the board, I think it's obvious that with technology in classrooms, the efficiency in education, it goes up. With technology, everybody wins.